Oh, that's a stonking one. Look at that.
Yes, that was shot locally. You see the bullet wound to the right-hand side.
Did it get the bullet wound since it's been in here, or what?
Yeah. No, that was the actual fatal wound, and we ate the rest of it.
That's nice. Yeah, I like that a lot. Great look. That is just an absolute belter. It really is. Just the size and shape of the horn. They usually come out a lot flatter and wider, and this one's raised right up and they're curling over and back in. It's almost like a skull framed by a horned love heart, you know. It's really got it all going on. Then it's got a brilliant thing. It's got a great big bullet hole right through the head, which is so gruesome. But thinking about sales-wise, it really adds to it.
The unmounted water buffalo skull and horns dates from the 19th century. Its battered look reflects its age, which adds to its sculptural appeal, and it could be worth around £600.
So you got £575 on it, so what are you doing? What can you do?
£575, we'd do it for you. No bibby, £500.
I am going to bid you.
I knew you would.
I can't help it, it's in my nature. I was really happy at £450, and I'd take it, yeah.
So at £475 you can, but at £450 you can't.
Just can't. I'll have it.
There you are. There you are. We'll get the bullet out of the head for you. Yeah.
That one's exceptional. So I'll pay up for that because it's exactly what we're looking for all rolled into one. And when you put something in front of you that is the best, you've got to buy it. And that one's the best one I've seen.
And there's another item that's caught his attention.
See this inkwell of the sort of fighting dog?
Yes.
That. All right, let's get that out. Mm.
Of course.
French, 19th century. Love the dog's face on it. It's just a great look. It's a sort of French Mastiff come fighting dog. With it is a faux bamboo quill with a matching little Mastiff's head on it. Just charming.
Developments in the way ink was produced in the early 19th century meant that more households had access to ready-made bottles of it. This led to an increase in demand for desktop inkwells. With the Victorian passion for nature and wildlife, they were often made in animal form. This cast iron French version is in good condition and could be worth around £400.
So we've got 200 on this 68. And 68 on that.
So it's over the 20%, but I'd like to £200 if I could.
Yeah. Well, I don't want to see them separated, and I know that it's going
I'll sell. Well, it's going to a home that's going to sell them straight away.
Yeah. Okay.
Can we do a deal? £200?
Well, thanks.
Thank you. Great.
Oh, look at that. What a great thing.
Yeah, I think it might be.
What is it?
I don't know. It's.
What a thing, look at that.
Yeah. Red Indians. Moccasin shoes.
The strange thing, it's all plaster, including this. The wooden frame is plaster.
A little bit of vintage marketing material from the 1950s, the cast plaster relief of a Native American is promoting a brand of shoes called moccasins. Drew sees it as just the quirky kind of item that could sell well. It could be worth around £180.
It's so convincing that it's wood, and it's not, it's just plaster, because clearly these would have been mass-produced by the hundreds and gone out to all the different distributors all over the world of these moccasin shoes, which I should imagine are made in America.
How much is that?
Yeah, be 20.
Sold. This is
yeah,
great. Brilliant.
Field day.
What a thing.
Lovely. What a You're happy? Thing.
I'm happy.
The image in the centre is great, the colour's good, and the manufacturing method is odd. And then, after all that, it's absolutely no money to buy as well. Ah, what's that? Like that.
It's woven 1/12 original scale, because the first time we wove it was for Queen Mary's Doll's House, which is
this
on
was
display.
For Queen Mary's Doll's House?
Yeah, yeah.
I want it more now.
And all the fabrics, and within it had to be 1/12 original scale, so all the furniture was cabinet made, the books for the library were actually properly printed. It's the finest quality you can buy.
This is the finest silk you can buy in the world?
Yeah. You can't get a better grade silk than that anywhere.
Man, that is just so special. How, out of all of those, did that one sort of go, oh, hello, pick me? I don't know, but it's perfect. It's got this wonderful texture, and it's got this incredibly fine pattern work all the way through it. And then when you roll it in your hand, it sort of changes colour. It's almost just changes with the light. It's just wonderful stuff.
Queen Mary's Doll's House was designed by architect Edwin Lutyens and finished in 1924. It showcased the best of Edwardian craft. This fabric, used in some of the miniature rooms, was made here out of organzine silk, twisted from single filament threads rather than spun. It could be worth around £150 per metre.
So we've got on there 5 metres. What would you want for that?
It'd be quite expensive, that.
What sort of?
Sort of 100 quid a metre.
For 500 quid?
Yeah. Mm. It's pretty unique, that.
Pretty special, isn't it? Could you do it for about £65 a metre?
I could do it for about £85 a metre. Yeah.
I've got to have that, haven't I?
Yeah.
Got to have that.
Great. Brilliant.
That's fantastic.
I know you'll make something special.
Yeah, I have got some lovely piece of furniture, and that will just be perfect. I'm over the moon with that.
My luck is in here today. Just wonderful. I mean, what a resource for me alone. What a resource.
Can I have a look?
Yeah, sure. Have a look. Yeah, absolutely do. Oh,
love the colour. Just a great big size as well, isn't it? It's a whopper.
What is it, 40s?
No, it's earlier than that. It's just into the 20th century.
Yes. The ladies here knew what they were doing. They were early salvage hunters.
This Edwardian leather armchair echoes the style of earlier great furniture makers like Howard & Son and Shoolbred. It's exactly the kind of piece Drew wanted to find, as quality-made English furniture with age is always popular with his clients. This chair, once cleaned up, could be worth around £1,000.
It's in really good condition. It's hardly been sat in. The scale of the chair is interesting. It's very deep. You find that with a lot of these large country house armchairs. Almost all, I can't put my feet on the ground if I sit right back in it. The scale is good, it's large because it's in a really large room. I like to buy particularly the late 19th century into early 20th century. They are the most comfortable and they have basically the most profit in them for me as well.
I think I'd pay £500 for it. What do you think, for sale?
For me, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, if Katrine's happy, I'm happy.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. This there, is that a period one?
Yeah,
got that right. A bit of age to it. Have you got any more of these?
Got loads downstairs waiting for
you. Of this type?
No, it's the Killam flat woven ones. No, yeah. I don't think I have.
All right, how much is it?
£100.
Oh, yes, please, thank you very much. Got any more?
150.
Too quick, that was it.
Yeah. Oh, well, it's far too quick.
Yeah, lovely.
Damn it.
We've got some more to see of those.
Yeah, I've got loads of rugs down in the other room.
Finding a run of rugs is exactly the sort of deal Drew was hoping for at such a big antiques emporium, as long as they're up to scratch.
So what we got in here, then?
Got some lovely rugs.
That's what I want at the minute.
These are...
What are they, saddlebags?
These are huge saddlebags, yeah. But normally these would go... Loops would go through here.
Yeah.
And then a stick go through all of these all the way along.
Yeah, and then over the top of the donkey or mule or whatever.
That's it. Camel, even. But normally they get cut in half, don't they? Because they make two fantastic...
Well, I'm thinking exactly the same, just cut it in half and make it into two cushions.
A pair of cushions. Oh, there's another one here.
All right, so how much are they?
£65 each.
65 quid each. What's that carpet there, that small one?
That's a little antique one. 70 quid.
Can you do them all at 60 each and I'll have them all?
Drew, don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Here's a Nelson! 20 quid. 15 quid. 45 quid.
Yep, we'll have that as well. There was one in the hallway that I liked the look of as well. Can I bring that in?
A big one, yeah.
Can I bring it in? They're a lovely thing to have in the house, even if they're placed across the top of a carpet or layered up, you know. And if you look at really old country house pictures, you'll see these rugs layered one over the other. So when one's worn out, they've just chucked another one down.
Jasper, are you coming to help me sell some carpets to Drew? You keep your fleas to yourself, mind.
That's a Persian rug.
Really?
A real one, yeah.
That's gorgeous.
It's the real deal. Look at that. £295 you got on the ticket.
£230, Drew. Bargain for
you. I'm buying a Persian rug for £230. Thank you very much.
A genuine Persian rug, made in the country now known as Iran, is hand-knotted, not machine-made, and made entirely of natural fibres, with rich colour on both back and front. Drew spends £865 on a total of 10 carpets, the pièce de résistance being the Persian one.
It's adding that thing that I want at the moment, which is colour. Simple palette to the background, then loads of colour all over it. I think that, for me, is what I'm about at the right now.